Dear friends, colleagues, hello everybody. My name is Zoran Stevanovic, and this is my pleasure to share with you my experience and my knowledge about the groundwater in Serbia, and also to be your guide in a tour on hydrogeology and history of exploration, current states, and our experience in dealing with problems in hydrogeology in Serbia. As I said, I'm Zoran. My professional career was for the all-time academic one. I spent all my career now as a young retired professor at the University of Belgrade in a center of karst hydrogeology department with the same name at the Faculty of Mining and Geology. I had also a good international experience. For some time, I was chair of the karst commission of IIH, and also I work in Serbia and abroad as a UN consultant for the organization FAO and UNESCO. In my time, in my full time, I wrote also number of the papers in hydrogeology. I also had the pleasure to be one of the editors of three books, all three dealing mostly with the karst aquifer system, which is my narrow specialization. Now I'm also working on another thing for the groundwater project. I'm working together with my friends and colleagues, with John Gunn, Nico Goldscheider, and Natasha Ravbar, on a new edition, Karst, Environment, Aquifers and Management. And I'm really glad and I'm congratulate to John Cherry for this excellent idea to have a groundwater project, which is a fantastic tool for promoting and educating people in a groundwater topics. I'm coming from Serbia, the country which some people are mixing with Siberia, which is a part of Russia. Serbia is another place, is a country in southeastern Europe, covers some 88,000 square kilometer. It is not big country, it is just maybe peanut if we compare with some other very large world countries. But still, in this part of the world, in the southeastern Europe and the Balkans Peninsula, this is one of the largest countries, populated with some 7 million inhabitants. And the country where which capital is Belgrade, town with some 1.7 million people, lays in rivers Danube and Sava, at the confluence of these two rivers, and became day by day modern European city with a long history and a tradition. University of Belgrade, it is a main educational organization in the country. It is comprises 31 faculties, which are organized into four groups. There are also 11 research institutes, eight university centers, and a more than 300 study programs, which attended by some 80,000 students in average, which coming not only from our country, but also from neighbor countries. And in the past, there were many students from the third world countries also educated in Belgrade. The topics which I today will present you, there are several of them. It is not easy to have a presentation in 20 minutes and to say everything about hydrogeology, even for a small country like my one. But however, I decided to give you basic information on each of these topics. First, an overview of the groundwater. Then I will talk about the karst aquifer, which is my favorite topics. Then something about the climate changes and their impact on the groundwater in this part of the world. Then some solution against the climate changes and their impact, such as managing aquifer recharge. Then some things about the groundwater pollution and the treats. Then aquifer vulnerability assessment, some geothermics aspects, and then about education as a key for sustainability. Tradition in hydrogeology is very long in Serbia. In we use as a milestone year 1897 when our geologist Svetolik Radovanović published the book Groundwater. In fact, this is a something that we are celebrating as a real beginning. And that was the first synthetic hydrogeological work, not only in Serbia, but also in the Southeastern Europe and the Balkans. It containing an analysis of all basic hydrogeological terms, aquifer, source, well, thermal and mineral waters. And this book is in the same time a popular and a serious scientific work, monograph, and the textbook we are often referring to in our work. Jovan Cvijić is another important person in Serbian geology and hydrogeology. He did his doctoral thesis in Vienna in 1893. The book Das Karst Phenomenon became somehow the beginning of karstology and the karst hydrogeology for that time. He was an eminent geographer, geologist, cartologist, karstologist, received many prizes all over the world, among them also gold medal of American Geographical Society. You can see it even on this slide. He made many, many excursions, which are not easy in that time. Visited many places, many springs described, put some theory about the groundwater circulation in the karst, and we are very proud on his past work. Hydrogeological map on Serbia, you can see it here. It is complex geology, and as a result, we have a very heterogeneous hydrogeological settings. We have some formation which are not rich in groundwater, such as Paleozoic formation, metamorphic rocks, Cretaceous flysch, and the thick sedimentary basins. This is sometimes there are fissure aquifer or even aquitards in them, while the next are the groups of the aquifer system, leading by the alluvial aquifer, which is rich in the groundwater extended along the major rivers. Then we have karst aquifers with abundant reserves in the western part of the Serbia. This is the yellow color in this map. And also in the eastern part where the Carpathian volcanic karst is extended. We have also this, which is in blue, remaining blue. This is a Neogene and the Pleistocene sediments, very thick in the northern part in Pannonian Basin. Sometimes they are reaching the thickness of 4,000, even 5,000 meters. And we have most of that area that is supplied by the groundwater from Artesian or confined aquifer system. So you can see on this small sketch tectonic map in the down left corner that we have several structures which meet each other just in the center of Serbia. Serbia is one of the six republics of the former Yugoslavia, and that country was among the richest in the by the water in the Europe. In fact, each citizen has some more than 5,000 cubic meter annually for each, and groundwater reserves were estimated at over 250 cubic kilometers per year. Serbia is a transit country, and many of its surface water are international. In fact, nowadays, after the Yugoslavia collapsed in some 30 years ago after the civil war, and now the former internal rivers such as Sava or Drina are now international, while the Danube and Tisa are another large river which are crossing Serbia. The major internal catchment is the Morava River, and there are many, many small internal and transboundary watercourses. Average specific runoff in Serbia is near 6 liters per second per square kilometers, while the lowest is in the northern part of the country in Vojvodina province, where is falling to just about 2.5 liters per second per square kilometers. So our people often say that water is tasty and healthy if it passes over 7 stones. This is exactly implication of the groundwater, which is a major source of population water supply. And now more than 70%, about 75% of the Serbian citizens are consuming the groundwater for drinking purposes. The first artesian in that time, artesian wells have been drilled in the mid of 19th centuries in the northern part, which in that time belonged to the Austro-Hungarian Empire, while the major and the today largest and oldest system supplying citizen of Belgrade. It is constructed in the Sava alluvium by numbers of the wells in 1892. Until the Second World War, Serbia was supplying population not more than about 10% that had a tap water, while this number increased to about 80% of the population just in next about 50 years. Until mid-80s, this percentage significantly increased. There are more than 1,000 water sources that was developed in Serbia, which included tapped springs, well fields, and there are also 4,000 rural systems for local water supply. Specific water consumption is about 220 liters per day per capita. And on that table, you can see that what is the groundwater use in Serbia per regions, but I will just put your attention on the alluvium aquifer, where the about 12 cubic meter per second of water is used. Also the karst aquifer, more than 4 cubic meter per second. And in total, this is a capacity of sources which using the groundwater, but in fact, the utilization is a little bit smaller. It's a little bit about 20 cubic meter per second. This is actual use. The major cities in the Serbia, except two or three, like Užice and Kruševac, which are using the surface water from the reservoir, majority of other are utilize the groundwater either from alluvial or from karstic aquifer. The largest system is Belgrade, where the more than 100 collectors wells of the Reni types are tapping between 3.5 to 4.5 cubic meter per second. Some 20 years ago, this amount was larger. There was more than 6 cubic meter per second utilized, but due to the in the meantime, constructed the system for also utilization of the surface water and for the its treatment. This is a little bit small. This amount is smaller nowadays. So you can see this one of the typical section of the Belgrade alluvium, where you have about 20 to 15, depending on the site, a thick gravel and the sand material, which is covered by the sandy and then clays, which are somehow protecting water from surface pollution. Here is also a list of the major cities which are using the utilize almost all of them groundwater. The Belgrade, as I said, is a leader in the capital. Belgrade is a leader in this group. Groundwater potential is about 3.5 times larger just if we consider the natural replenishment groundwater, or as we are often saying dynamic groundwater reserves. So assessment is that we have available about 67 cubic meter per second of this naturally replenished water, which is, as you can see, as you saw, three times larger than actual water consumption. Now we will say a few words about the karst aquifer, which is the second in magnitude regarding the second in range regarding the groundwater utilization. As I said, there are Dinari karst in Serbia in the eastern part, in the western part, and Carpathian karst in the east. So this is the Carpathian and Dinari karst, which are, I could say, meet each other in Serbia, are the two branches of the Alpine orogenic belt. So there are all often considered Dinari karst as a classical karst or homeland of the karst. And if I back to the one large project is the World Karst Aquifer Mapping, which I had also opportunity to join together with Nico Goldschneider as a leader and a few other colleagues. We found that the highest density of the largest karst springs in the world is exactly in the Dinari karst in the southeastern Europe. So you can even see from that map. In that number, even eight springs from Bosnia-Herzegovina and Montenegro 5 have the minimal discharge greater than 2 cubic meters per second. So some country also in this region, like Montenegro with more than 75%, or Albania and Austria with more than 50%, are utilizing the karst aquifer water. So in one of these diagrams, you can even see that one coincidence and correlation between the karst outcrops and also the population percentage which are using the karst water for drinking purpose. Leader is definitely Montenegro with 75% of the territory and more than 85% of people which are utilizing the karst groundwater. Serbia is not that rich about, but you see also about 20% is covered by karst and about 20% of the population are consuming groundwater. Here are also some other European country in this diagram. Now, I would like to make one brief tour about 3 minutes with you through one recent book, which my friend Neven Krešić and I did about the creating the 10 chapters in a book with 500 photos, fantastic photos from the karst of our region, and a book which we appreciated and very much together with many of our colleagues, and which we dedicated to this year, which is declared as an international year of caves and karst. So please enjoy. Thank you.
wash all the dirt on the riverside. Go to the water so very near, the river will be yours and ease. I'll walk to the borders on my own, fall in the water just like a stone, chill to the marrow.
This was just a short story about the karst, about its beauties, and now just maybe a few words about its potential. If we compare specific groundwater discharge in the countries around, you can see that in Serbia, this is about 3.16, it's the middle of this long list, and the leader is Montenegro, with more than 11 liters per second per square kilometer, just a concern considering the groundwater discharge. Some other country I also put in this list just to be comparable. They also have, for instance, karst like Somalia or Iraq, where while the their specific yield is very small. When we look to the groundwater reserves per capita, we could also see that available groundwater is more than 20 cubic meter per person per day formally, and the its utilization rate is very low, while in Serbia it's a 10 times lesser if we compare this list, but still is a considerable amount. Climate changes and pressure on aquifer system will increase. We are all witnessing many of these new modeling and results of these models. One of the largest projects we have also participated in was Climate Changes and Water Supply, CC Waters project, which comprised the 9 countries from the Southeastern Europe, and regional modeling, which we also applied, showed that we will have some decrease in a groundwater discharge of the specifically in the karstic aquifer, which is one of the most vulnerable, and we will have reduction of some springs with a more than 20% comparing an average, while in the already problematic summer and autumn time, we would have in some springs minus 40% of the water we are having now. So this is not an optimistic scenario. We also try to develop some new models and new methods for assessing vulnerability of the karstic aquifer. You can see one of such attempts. It is published paper recently, whereby based on the 4 parameters, permeability, storativity, discharge, and slope, we impose some method to assessing where we have to pay more attention and see how to deal with the problems of groundwater reduction. Monitoring is a key factor for preparing these responses on the climate change, but is in my country still is not sufficient. You can see these violet dots on the red on the right map. Most of piezometers are located along the major rivers and not well distributed across entire country. And this is when we compare with the delineated groundwater bodies, which was one of the tasks in implementation of the Water Framework Directive of European Union, out of 153 delineated groundwater bodies, only in 20% of them we have a proper monitoring of the groundwater quantity and groundwater quality. In order to somehow overcome this gap, we completed several projects in the last 10 years, starting with a project of the monitoring of groundwater, then expansion of the groundwater monitoring network, which we work together, university and the leading institution, Geological Survey of Serbia, and the Institute of Water Management, and also for Ministry of Environmental Protection, we recently complete one project, so-called operational monitoring. Managing aquifer recharge will be one of the solutions to combat this problem of groundwater reduction as a result of the climate changes. In Serbia, there is a big prospect for utilization of this recharge, of this method of this recharge. An assessment say that we have about 40 cubic meter per second of water that we can inject and in fact recharge the ground in order to have new groundwater from the major aquifer system, alluvium. And currently we utilize just about 1 cubic meter per second. The larger system is constructed and implemented for the third largest system in Serbia. This is city of Niš, whereby 9 infiltration ponds and the number of the wells, the initial capacity of 270 liters per second doubled, and more than 600 liters per second is the current exploitation rate of such a system. We also did several successful regulation projects of the karst aquifer. The largest of them is the regional water system Bogovida, whereby after the very intense and the complex hydrogeological investigation, we by 4 wells, we tapped out discharge of about 300 liters per second, which is the 4-fold larger than the natural spring discharge in that area. So it means we expand, we increase capacity, and the system is functioning very well. And in order to have a really environmentally friendly solution, we even introduce and we drill some wells and pumping water to return as a return flow to the river due to the smaller, its smaller yield after the system being constructed. For mention city, source of niche, there are also another karstic spring where we also, Institute of Water Management, Jaroslav Černi, introduced the system, which is in fact enabled by the 2 wells to pump the water during the period of the low water and in fact the capacity of city was satisfied. Now about the groundwater which are under treats, pressure on the groundwater quality increase, and we have several cases of accidental groundwater pollution. For instance, just with the petroleum products, there are during the about 15 years there were more than 10 such a kind of the accidents. The largest one happened in Belgrade in 1984, where xylol or dimethylbenzene was in about 45 tons were after the railway accident went to the ground, and this plume of the groundwater been in fact luckily neutralized by the pumping, by the extraction well, and more or less it is remediation was successful. There were several other similar accidents and several others attempts to remove materials to put extraction wells and to somehow reduce the negative consequences of the accident. The mining industry pollutants are also present. We have a very intense extraction of the copper and the other minerals, and you can see these typical mine water which are polluted the main streams, some of them being treated, but we have also some abandoned mines where from which water is freely flow out still. In order to make an assessment of the vulnerability of groundwater, the Serbia was, according to my knowledge, one of the very few countries which is beginning of the 21st century, create the aquifer vulnerability map for entire territory for in a scale 1 to 500,000. The method is done, our authentic method, with five input components, assessing slope, aquifer systems, depth to the groundwater, overlying layer, and the soil. And based on these five criteria, we establish this map, which is used for general spatial planning in the country. After that, we also create groundwater hazard map in a scale 1 to 500,000, and also risk map of Serbia in the same scale, 1 to 500,000. We assessing this based on the diffuse pollutants assessment. Finally, when we are talking about the pressure on groundwater quality, our studies found that about 20% of the groundwater bodies are potentially or already at risk, while for 80% we could still say that they are in a good condition, mainly due to the unpopulated areas, not intensive industry, and somehow properly introduced preventive measures to in a water management. Our story will come to its end slowly by assessing and saying a few words about the geothermal potential. Serbia is rich due to the complex geology with the thermal springs. There are 160 recorded, where the temperature is average temperature is above 15 degrees centigrade. The highest temperature in Vranjska Banja Spa is 96, and there are few others with a temperature over 70 degrees centigrade. There are also yield of recorded 62 artificial geothermal wells in the province of Vojvodina, and their total potential is about 0.5 cubic meter per second, and the heat capacity about 50 megawatts. So Serbia and the central part of Serbia is also, according to the heat flow density, is relatively rich. You can see in the down left corner, map of Europe, you see, of course, a leader is Iceland, then Italy, Greece, Turkey. They have a larger heat potential, but then after area in France and in Central Europe, including Serbia, is also rich with a flow density larger than 100 milliwatts per square meter. And some structures in the northern part of the country, in this Pannonian Basin, we have a potential to tap the water with a temperature over 150 degrees centigrade from the depth larger than the 3,000 meters. Another area which are very promising for utilization of geothermal potential is name is Mačva. It's in close to the Sava Graben, a tectonic graben, where there are several deep wells where the water flow out with a temperature over 70 degrees centigrade. Vranjska Banja and few others are still this not properly utilized potential, and we hope in a time ahead we will have much better situation concerning utilization. Geothermal energy is utilized for balneology, for greenhouses, and the soil and heating and the space heating. And our story will finish with the education in hydrogeology as a long tradition. Faculty of Mining and Geology is the main institution with more than 100 professors in these two disciplines, geology and mining, while Department of Hydrogeology, which I was for last 40 years a member, is just celebrating this year its 50th anniversary, and we are very proud of the fact that we educated more than 900 students, which have been graduated, which is giving an average of 17 hydrogeological engineers in average per year. Center of Kars Hydrogeology is one of centers which are acting at the university and the Faculty of Mining and Geology. We also had a good international experience working in some countries in the Middle East, in Africa, and also in the former Yugoslavian country, and in the different discipline. Among our activities, also international course, characterization and engineering of Kars aquifer, since the year 2014, with the sponsorship of UNESCO and several other institutions, including American University and the Kars Commission of the IIH, and also IGRAC Center from Holland, Edwards Aquifer from San Antonio, we had the opportunity to host more than 100 participants from 24 countries, and they have been lectured by the 20 professors from a different country, and they rotated almost every year, but the core being always the professors from University of Belgrade. So in the last year, the course was online and also attended by more than 100 participants. So with this facts about the education, I would like to send you regards on behalf of my colleagues of Serbian hydrogeologists, and for all of you who are interesting or you are already acting as a young researcher or professionals or decision makers, maybe, I will wish you to pay more attention on the groundwater as an invisible resource, and with my call to make it as much as more visible to all. Thank you. Thank you for your attention, and have a good day. Bye.